The host agreement was signed and it was good for an initial period of 10 years. And that period ended in 1993. And then it was renewed for another 5-year term. The end of that term is this August. And so it is up for renewal this August.
No, I really took a job.
The PDA is now deciding whether to change the Hills Agreement, whether to not change the Hills Agreement, or to change the Hills Agreement with renewal, with changes. We have decided, after getting some feedback from some three study groups that we set up, to make some changes to the Hills Agreement, the agreement that governs the management of the market, one of the documents that governs the management of Pike Place Market, farm tables and craft tables. So we decided to recommend to the city, or ask the city for a renewal of the Hills Agreement with some specific changes.
One
of the main objectives in the Hills Agreement and in Charter, another governing document for the market, is to promote the sale and of fresh produce to local consumers in Seattle. And one of our main purposes is to promote farmers like you who sell fresh edible produce to local consumers. Or in general, we support farmers, all farmers, and we support craftspeople, and we support low-income residents. But one of the fundamental objectives is to promote the sale of produce, locally grown edible produce, from this area to local consumers. And the changes that we have, or the basic changes that we're recommending to the Hills Agreement, are intended to facilitate, to encourage the promotion of that objective.
Yeah,
Okay, so the basic most important recommendation that we are making in our proposal is to provide farmers who sell fresh edible produce the opportunity to take an extra 4-foot table space when there's extra farm tables available. The intention is not to take away tables from farmers, other farmers that are selling flowers, they're selling honey, they're selling processed jams. The intention is to use whatever farm priority tables are left after everybody's gotten their two tables, their 2 4-foot tables, the opportunity to select another 4 feet of table space. And that's what our basic objective is. There's other changes that we're recommending, and I'll touch on those, but I just want to get that one out right now on the table so we can work with that a little bit. So, an example of a situation in which we would be putting into place this new change would be, let's say there's a day when 30 farmers...
Sorry, we need some more chairs. There's several people here who want to come in. So we hand some chairs back.
There's about 4 back here.
Okay.
Let me just clearly state that our purpose, our objectives with the changes is not to take away tables from farm tables from anybody. Our purpose is to use farm priority tables for farm use. And when there is extra table space available, we would allow farmers selling exclusively fresh edible produce an extra 4 feet of table space. And then after those farmers that are selling fresh edible produce get their extra 4 feet of table space, any other tables left over would go to craft and priority use. So basically, what we're trying to do is sort of find a balance where there's farmers that are selling this kind of product. We provide whatever opportunities we can to give them the sort of space they need to sell the product in the time that they're here. Most of you I'm sure know that if you're selling all produce, you basically, in order to move it, you need the space to move it, and you have a very short time frame in order to move the space. And our goal is basically to make that happen and to give some benefit to those farmers that are selling that product while not taking away from other farmers that are selling other products. It's not to say that what you're selling is wrong or it's not, you don't want it. It's just to say that during those times when those farmers that are selling this kind of product that are tend to be the that tend to have a very, very short shelf life, that tend to need more space in order to move them, that have a low margin of return in terms of crop and everything like this, should in the short, in the few times of the year, get some sort of extra sort of acknowledgement and space for that. There are some other changes that we have that we're proposing to the rules that we use to govern the market. And one of them would be we're proposing changing the ability to charge different rental rates for different types of products. And basically what that would mean is that, one example of what that would mean is that somebody that's selling a product that has a really low sort of marginal return in terms of the profitability of the product maybe charge less for a second table space than a farmer or a craftsperson or somebody else selling a product that has a higher margin of returns, basically providing the opportunity for farmers that are selling the kind of products that don't generate as much revenue to have a table space, an extra table space for less.
Another
change that we're proposing is to slightly alter the appeals process. Everybody in this room has the right to appeal a decision by the market master when the market master makes a decision on space allocation, permits. They can come to the PDA and request an appeal of a decision. And we're proposing a change, slight modification to the current rules that would allow us to eliminate one step in the process that would streamline the process somewhat and also make the entire process specific to farmers, craftspeople, and reformers. So basically, the goal is to streamline the appeals procedure as it stands now in the Hill Street.
Another
change we're proposing. Thank you.
Thank you.